Welcome to Stable Sort. In this episode, we're going to discuss a so-called partition problem, where you're asked to partition a set of positive integers into two subsets, such that the sum of the numbers in each subset adds up to the same amount as closely as possible. This is an NP-complete problem, dubbed as the easiest hard problem. First, we're going to develop a recursive solution to it with the source code walkthrough, and then we'll discuss a completely different solution that's based on dynamic programming. Restating the problem definition, given a set of positive integers, split it into two subsets such that the sum of the numbers in each subset adds up to the same amount as closely as possible. In this example, the optimal way of partitioning this set is like so. For this problem, we're going to assume that we're dealing with multisets, meaning the sets are not restricted to have unique numbers. Therefore, we'll use arrays to be able to store duplicate numbers.
Okay, everyone out.
First, note that you can easily loop over the input array, calculate the total, and then divide that number in half. Let's call that our target because both the partitions would need to add up to this target as closely as possible. We can make things a little easier if our function were to just return one of the partitions. Later on, we can trivially select all the remaining numbers to construct the second partition. With that, our function begins to take shape. It takes in an input array of integers and a target value, which is half of the total sum of values across the whole array. As with all recursive functions, you want to chip away at the solution with each recursive call. In our case, we are to decide if a value at a particular index in the array is to be selected or not. This means we'll also need to pass in the array index as well. So we'll start off by calling this function with I equals 0. The main decision to make is whether to select the value at index I or to skip it. If we were to select it, it would mean that the rest of the array, from index I plus 1 all the way to the end, can be used to select the values that add up to the target minus the value at index I. The other possibility is that we don't select the value at index I, which would mean that the rest of the array could still be used to select the values that add up to the same unchanged target. Suppose we already have a magically implemented function that somehow returns an optimally selected list of values that add up to a desired target. Then we can call this function twice to check both of the possibilities. All that is left to do now is check which of the two lists comes closer to the target and return the best one. This part of the function is trivial. It just sums up the values in each list, and the diff function checks which of the sums is closer to the target. With the addition of the first line that returns an empty set once we reach the end of the array, our function is now complete. There are a few optimizations that you can make to improve the performance of this function at certain circumstances. For example, you could halt immediately as soon as you find the sum of the first list to be exactly the target amount. But as it stands, our function evaluates every possible combination of subsets, which leads to an exponential running time. In other words, no matter how powerful your computer is, it's going to choke on an input array of as little as 50. Which leads us to the second solution that uses dynamic programming. Now, if you happen to be one of our regular viewers, you may recall an episode called 01 Knapsack. It just so happens to be that the solution to the 01 Knapsack problem could be used directly to solve our partition problem. As a quick refresher, the 01 Knapsack is defined as follows. You're given a set of items that each have a value and a weight. The challenge is to pick a subset of these items, maximizing the total value, while being constrained by some maximum capacity of the knapsack. We can set both the value and the weight of each item to the values from our input array. The max capacity would just be our target, and now we can call 01 knapsack, and it'll give us back an array of zeros and ones indicating which value is going to the first set and which going to the second set. There's no point of me repeating the solution to the 0-1 Knapsack problem. All of that is discussed in full glorious detail in the other episode, so I encourage you to watch it, and it's linked in the description. But I would like to mention that the dynamic programming solution constructs a two-dimensional table, the sides of which are proportional to the number of items in the array and the maximum capacity value. This means that two inputs of the same size array could have very different running times just based on the values in the array. These types of algorithms are said to have weakly polynomial running time. Even though the constructed table is two-dimensional, this is not a quadratic algorithm. It could perform much better than the recursive function we came up with earlier, being able to handle arrays of size not just 50, but possibly 50,000 or more. But it all hinges on the values that are in the array, with larger values resulting in longer running time. In fact, you could pick the values to be exponentially larger in proportion to the size of the array, and then the algorithm would have exponential running time, just like the recursive function. One final thought. What if the problem was to create three partitions as opposed to just two, or more generally k number of partitions? Could a pseudo-polynomial solution be developed in this scenario? More on that on our very next episode of Stable Sort. I would like to thank one of our viewers for suggesting the topic of this video. If you'd like to suggest a topic for a future episode, or you have any questions or comments, please use the comments section to let us know. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Please click that thumbs up button if you did, and thank you for watching.